Today I am going to discuss concavity, convexity and deflection. The curve is said to be concave upwards or concave downwards at a point P. If in the neighborhood of P, the curve lies above the tangent on both sides. Next, the curve is said to be concave downwards or convex upwards at a point P if in the neighborhood of P the curve is above the tangent on both sides. A point on the curve at which the curve changes from concavity to convexity is called the point of inflection. Once again, I repeat this one. The curve is said to be concave upwards or concave downwards if in the neighborhood of a point P, the curve is below the tangent. The curve is below the tangent on both sides. The curve is said to be concave upwards or convex downwards if in the neighborhood of a point P, the curve lies below the tangent. The curve lies below the tangent on both sides. A point on the curve at which the curve changes from concavity to convexity or vice versa is called the point of inflection. Now let's go to the problem section. Examine for concavity, convexity and point of inflection for y is equal to sin x. Y is equal to sin x given that differentiate sin x derivative cos x, d squared y by ds squared is minus sin x. In, I am dividing in the interval, here question is in the interval 0 comma 2 pi. In 0 comma 5, d square by ds square less than d square y by ds square less than 0, because in 0 to pi sin is positive, therefore minus into positive we get minus itself, therefore y is concave downwards. A condition for concave downwards is second derivative is less than 0 or negative. Condition for concave upwards, second derivative is positive or greater than 0. Next, in pi to 2 pi, in between 180 to 2 pi, sine function is negative. Therefore, minus into sine function is negative in between 180 to 360. Therefore, minus into minus plus. Therefore, d square by ds square greater than 0. Therefore, y is concave upwards, because if second derivative is positive or greater than 0, y is concave upwards. If it is negative, second derivative is negative, we say that concave downwards. Next, find the points of inflection on the curve y is equal to log x whole cube. I am considering y is equal to log x whole cube. Differentiate this one, 3 log x whole power 2, 3 minus 1 means 2, log x derivative 1 by x. We know that derivative f to the power of n formula, n f to the power of n f to the power of n minus 1 into d by ds of f. I am using this formula, 3 log x whole power 2 into derivative log x is 1 by x. Again differentiate, I am using product rule. Log x whole square as first function I am taking, 1 by x as second function. First into derivative second, 1 by x derivative minus 1 by x squared. Second into derivative first, 2 log x into 1 by x. So from these two terms here, log by x squared I am taking, log divided by x squared as common, we get here minus log x, here remaining term is 2. Next, d square by ds squared is equal to 0, equating second derivative equating to 0, equate this one. So here we get cross multiply this one, after simplification log x is equal to 0, imply x is equal to 1 because log 1 is 0. Next, minus log x plus 2 is equal to 0, log x is equal to 2, x is equal to e squared. Next, when x is equal to 1 here, in this particular case, when x is equal to 1, log 1 is 0. Well, put x is equal to e squared. Here we get log e squared whole cube. Therefore, 2 log e whole cube. 2 cube means 8. Log e means 1. Therefore, 8. The point of inflection are 1 comma 0. X is 1, y is equal to 0. 1 comma 0. X is equal to e squared, y is equal to 8. The point of inflection are 1 comma 0 and e squared comma 8. That's all. Find the points of inflection on the curve x is equal to log of y by x. So x is equal to, given that, log y by x. This becomes if e power x is equal to y by x, because we know that x is equal to log f. This imply if we take e power x is equal to, I am converting logarithmic form to exponential form. So e power x, if we take e, we get e power x is equal to y by x. Therefore, x e power x is equal to y, y is equal to e power x. Differentiate x into e power x, e power x into 1. So dy by dx is equal to, if you take e power x as common, e power x of x plus 1. Next, differentiate d squared y by dx squared, e power x into 1, x plus 1 into e power x. If you take e power x as common, we get 1 plus x plus 1. So here we get e power x of x plus 2. For d squared by dx squared is equal to 0, equating to 0, because the condition for point of inflection is second derivative is 0. Therefore, e power x of x plus 2 is equal to 0. So x plus 2 is equal to 0 because e power x not equal to 0. If you take any value, any real value for x, e power x not equal to 0. Therefore, x plus 2 should be equal to 0. X is equal to minus 2. X is equal to minus 2. Next, here, put x is equal to minus 2 in 1. So, y is equal to minus 2 e power minus 2. Therefore, minus 2 divided by e square. Therefore, the points of inflection, the point of inflection is minus 2 comma minus 2 divided by e square. Here the point of inflection is minus 2 comma minus 2 divided by e square. That's all. Show that the curve y is equal to x squared e power minus x has two points of inflection and find them. Given that y is equal to x squared e power minus x, dy by dx first function into derivative second, second into derivative first. Next, dy by dx is equal to, I am using product of x squared into e power minus x derivative minus e power minus x second into derivative first, x squared derivative 2x. Therefore, if you take e power minus x common, minus x square 2x. Again, differentiate. First function into derivative second. I am using product of first into derivative second. Minus 2x plus 2 into 1, 2. Next, second function into derivative first. Next, here, from these two terms, if you take e power minus x common, we get minus x plus 2. Multiply this one, minus into minus, plus x squared, minus 2x. So e power minus x, x squared minus 4x plus 2. So d squared y by dx squared. D squared y by dx squared is equal to 0. For d square by dx squared is equal to 0, because condition for point of inflection d square by dx squared is equal to 0. This implies e power minus x, x squared minus 4x plus 2 is equal to 0. X squared minus 4x plus 2 is equal to 0, because e power minus x not equal to 0. X squared minus 4x is equal to minus 2, add by 4, x squared minus 4x plus 4 minus 2 plus 4. This becomes x minus 2 whole square 2, therefore x minus 2 is equal to plus or minus root 2, x is equal to 2 plus or minus root 2. Therefore, the given curve has two points of inflection, because there are two values for x, one is 2 plus root 2, other one is 2 minus root 2, that's all. That y, show that y is equal to log x is convex upwards everywhere. So given that y is equal to log x, or dy by dx, 1 by x d square y by dx square minus 1 by x square less than 0, that's it. And therefore y is convex upwards. Y is convex upwards or concave downwards, both are same. Show that y is equal to log x convex upwards or concave downwards. That's all. Next, prove that y is equal to e power x is everywhere concave upwards. E power x d square by dx square e power x, this one is greater than 0 for all points. Therefore, your second derivative is positive, that reason y is equal to e power x is everywhere concave upwards. Concave upwards means we get like this. That's all. Find the intervals in which the curve f of x is equal to x cube minus 18x square plus 96 plus 4 is concave downwards. Given that f of x, x cube, 18x square, 96x plus 4. So we have dash of x, 3x square, 36x, 9. We have double dash of x, 6x minus 36. So for we have double dash of x is equal to 0, this implies 6x minus 36 is equal to 0, 6x is equal to 36, so x is equal to 6. X is equal to 6. When x is less than 6, f double dash of x is less than 0. Because if you take 5, less than 6 means 5, 30 minus 36 means minus 6, negative. Therefore, f of x is concave downwards in interval minus infinity comma 6, in the interval minus 6, less than 6, if you take any values, this second derivative becomes negative. If you get second derivative negative, therefore concave downwards. If you get second derivative positive, we say that concave upwards. Concave upwards. Here, when x is less than 6, second derivative is negative, therefore f of x is concave downwards in minus 6, minus infinity comma 6. That's all. Find a range of values of x for which the curve y is equal to e power minus x, x square plus 4x plus y is concave upwards. Y is equal to e power minus x, x square plus 4x plus y. Differentiate using product rule, first into derivative second, 2x plus 4 into 1 plus 0, so 2x plus 4. Next, second into derivative first, e power minus x is minus e power minus x. First into derivative second, second into derivative first. From these two terms, I am taking e power minus x as common. We get 2x plus 4 minus x squared minus 4x minus 5. So here we get minus x squared minus 2x minus 1. Again, from these term, if you take minus sign as common, so minus e power minus x, x squared plus 2x plus 1. x square plus 2x plus 1 can be written as x plus 1 whole square. Again, differentiate using product rule. First into derivative second. E power minus x as first function, x plus 1 whole square as second function I am taking. First into derivative second to x plus 1, 1, 0, x derivative 1, 1 derivative 0. Next, second into derivative first, e power minus x derivative minus e power minus x. Again, from these two terms, e power minus x has common, 2x plus 2 here, expand this one, x square plus 2x plus 1, if you multiply by minus then, minus x square minus 2x minus 1, here 2x, 2x gets cancels, here we get minus x square, 2 minus 1 means 1, here if you take negative sign inside, minus into minus plus x square minus 1, here for d square by d square is equal to 0, imply e power minus x, x square minus 1 is equal to 0, x square minus 1 is equal to 0, because e power minus x not equal to 0 if we take for all real values. Therefore, x square minus 1 should be equal to 0. X square is equal to 1, x is equal to plus or minus 1. Next, I am taking minus 1, 1. Values we get minus 1, 1. Here, I am taking minus infinity, infinity. I am taking, here we get first interval, minus infinity, comma, minus 1. Here, in this particular case, if you take in between minus infinity to minus 1 means, if you take minus 2 whole square means, e power 2, 4 minus 1 means we get 3 e square. If you take minus 3, 9 minus 1, 8, we get positive values. So, d square by d square greater than 0. If second derivative is positive, we say that concave upwards. Next, in the interval, second interval, minus 1, 1 to 1. So, in between minus 1 to 1, we get 0. If you take 0, here we get e power 0, 0 minus 1, we get here minus 1, negative. Therefore, d squared by d squared less than 0. If second derivative is less than 0, we say that y is concave downwards. If we get positive, we say that concave upwards. If we get negative, we say that concave downwards. Next interval, 1 comma infinity. If you take 1 to infinity means, if you take 2, 4 minus 1, 3. If you take 3, 9 minus 1, 8, we get positive values for second derivative. Therefore, d square by d square greater than 0. Therefore, y is concave upwards. Therefore, y is concave upwards in minus infinity comma minus 1 union 1 comma infinity. But if we consider minus 1 to 1, here we get concave downwards. That's the, I am not considering this part. Give us that. F of x is equal to 3x cube 9x squared 9x 15. So f dash of x 9x squared 18x plus 9. If we differentiate again, we get 18x 18 into 1 9 0. So if we differentiate this one, 3 into 3 9x squared, 2 into 9 18x, 9 into 1 means 9 itself, 15 is constant, derivative constant a 0. Again differentiate, 2 into 9, 18x, 18 into 1, 18 itself, 9 derivative 0. Next, for f double dash of x is equal to 0, we get 18 x minus 18 is equal to 0, 18 x is equal to 18, so x is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. Yeah, I am considering when x is less than 1. If we take like this, less than 1 we get here negative, this one. Here if we take x is greater than 1, f double dash of x greater than 0. Greater than 1 means take 2. If we take 2, 36 minus 18 means 18 itself positive. Therefore, f of x is concave upwards in the interval 1 comma infinity, 1 comma infinity. If we take less than 1, we get negative, we get concave downwards. That is, I am considering greater than 1. Next, point of inflection. put x is equal to 1 in 1, in 1. So here we get f of 1, 3 into 1, 9 into 1, 9 into 1, 15. Therefore, 9 n gets cancels, f of 1 is equal to 3 minus 15 means minus 12. Therefore, the point of inflection is 1 comma 12. The point of inflection is 1 comma minus 12. Find the intervals of convexity and concavity of f of x is equal to x minus 1 divided by x minus 2. X minus 1 divided by x minus 2, differentiate x minus 2 into 1, x minus 1 into 1, denominator into derivative of numerator. So 1 minus 0 means 1, numerator into derivative of denominator, 1 minus 0 means 1, so denominator whole square. So here we get x minus 2 minus x plus 1, so x minus 2 whole square. So here we get f dash of x is equal to minus of x minus 2 whole power minus 2. Next, again differentiate minus of minus plus 2, x minus 2 whole power minus 3, 1 minus 0. So f double dash of x is equal to 2 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. Minus into minus 2 means plus 2. X minus 2, minus 2 minus 1 means minus 3, 1 minus 0. So here when x is less than 2, so f dash of x less than 2 means if you take 1 we get negative, this one 0 negative, therefore less than 0, therefore f of x is convex concave downwards, concave downwards, or convex upwards in minus infinity comma 2 in the interval. Next, when x is greater than 2, so f dash of x greater than 0. So greater than 2 means if you take 3 positive, 4 positive, so second derivative greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is concave upwards or convex downwards in 2 comma infinity, in 2 comma infinity. That's all. Show that the curve a square plus x squared of y is equal to a squared x has 3 points of inflection. So a square plus x square of y, a squared x, y is equal to a squared x, a square plus x square. So dy by dx, a square plus x squared into a squared x into denominator into derivative of numerator, x squared into a squared x derivative 1, numerator into derivative of denominator 0, x squared derivative 2x, divided by a square plus x square whole square. So dy by dx is equal to a to the power of 4 a squared x squared, here 2 a squared x squared means a squared x squared. So a square plus x square whole square. Again differentiate. So d squared y by dx squared. Again I am using quotient rule. Denominator into derivative of numerator 0. So minus 2a squared x. 2a squared x minus numerator into derivative of denominator 2 of a square plus x squared into 2x, 0, 2x, divided by a square plus x square whole square. Here from these two terms, I am taking a square plus x square as common. So the remaining terms are 2a squared x. Next, here 2 into 2, 4x. 4x into a power 4 minus into minus plus 4a square x into x squared x cube divided by a squared x squared, this whole squared means 4 to the power of 4. So here a square plus a square, here a square plus a square whole to the power of 4. After simplification we get a square plus a square whole cube. So here simplify this one. Here in this particular case, if we take a square common minus 2x, otherwise if we take 2a squared x as common, so here we get 2a squared as a common 1, here 2 into a squared, so here we get 2x cube, 2x cube, a square plus x square whole cube. So this one equating to 0, here d square by, in this particular case, here once again explain this one. Y is equal to a squared x divided by a square plus a square, denominator into derivative of numerator, a squared into 1, a squared itself, a squared x into 0, 2x, so a squared x into 2x, so a squared into a squared, a to the power of 4, here a squared x squared minus 2 a squared means minus a squared x squared divided by a squared plus x squared whole square. Apply quotient rule, denominator into derivative of numerator 0, so 2 a square x. Next, numerator into derivative of denominator 2 of a square plus x square into 2x. So here from these two term I am taking, in this particular case, so here one term is missing. If you take a square plus x square common, a square plus x square minus 2a squared x. Next, so 4x of a power 4 a square x square divided by a square plus x square whole to the power of 4. Next, here multiply this one minus 2a power 4 minus 2a power 4 x minus 2a squared x cube. Next, 4x a power 4 plus 4 a squared x cube divided by a square plus x square whole cube. Next, in this particular case, 2a to the power 4 x, otherwise if you simplify this one, 2a power 4 x, here this one we get minus 6 a power 4 x. Next, here minus 2 a squared x cube, here plus 2 a squared x cube, so here a square plus x square whole cube. Here from these two term if you take here common, so here we get minus 2 a squared x common, so remaining term 3 a squared, 3 a squared, so here we get minus x square, therefore a square plus x square whole cube. Next, d square by d square equating to 0, for d square by d square is equal to 0, 2a squared x, 3a squared minus x square divided by a square plus x square whole cube is equal to 0, therefore here 2a squared x, 3a squared minus x squared is equal to 0. this one cross multiply from LHS to RHS, 0 into any term 0 itself. Next, x of 3a squared minus x squared is equal to 0 minus 2a squared equating to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 0. Next, 3a squared minus x squared is equal to 0. Therefore, minus x squared is equal to minus 3a squared. Therefore, x is equal to plus or minus root 3a. Here, we get three values for x. X is 0. X is equal to plus or minus root 3a. Here, substitute, we get three values. Therefore, the given curve has 3 points of inflection because we get three values for x. One is x is 0. Other one, x is equal to root 3a. Other one, x is equal to minus root 3a. X has three values. Therefore, the given curve has 3 points of inflection. That's all.